Hello and greetings from Iceland. It's time to do an update covering two locations this time, and I will be using the earthquake time-lapse format to see the larger picture, but you know I love to use that kind of presentation. And this is a sample of my work recently, or the colorful clouds in northern Iceland, but it's a bit tricky to make this good enough for stock agencies, so I'm still working on the techniques for this kind of footage. And let's start the update by Askja Volcano again, although I did mention it recently in my video while I was doing my prediction for 2023. However, we finally got some news, or this chart, which shows us that the land uplift from August 2021 has reached 50 centimeters, so this part of the Icelandic highlands is only getting higher, and it's remarkable to see how steadily the land has risen. And the missing dots can most likely be blamed on the Icelandic winter, since it's not so easy to get the signals from up there, from all the measuring devices. It's no electricity out there, and solar panels with hardly any sunlight this time of year are not very useful. And the same goes for tremors, but it just got the tremor chart again, where we can already see that Mother Earth is having some mood swings every now and then. So let's do the time-lapse that starts December 1st, when the unrest in November was just about to fade out, like we see. But it's still some unrest there to the north from Lake Askja, but this is how it goes, or unpredictable. And according to our fine scientists, it's most likely that this will just fade out, according to statistics. And they do say that it's remarkable how little seismic activity accompanies this huge land uplift, meaning that the magma tank under there at a depth of 2 to 4 kilometers is simply accepting all the magma without major complaints, indicating it's plenty of room for more. However, the scientists stated not so long ago that the magma intrusion was in fact very large. And let's move briefly over the image where we have the earthquakes accumulated. And it's worth noticing that when we look at Mount Herðubreið, the earthquakes there, they line up the classical way, or the same direction as the fissure swarms. But the land uplift was, however, detected further south by the lake, and this is how last year looked around there, all the earthquakes. And the land uplift there could be the reason for the nearby unrest that we were just looking at. And one of the questions I have now is whether it's possible that such an amount of magma will simply solidify without an eruption, and how large can a magma chamber get without an eruption? So feel free to educate me and my viewers if you know anything more about this. At least we know that all the equipment up there is up and running again, and it's plenty of reason to keep an eye on this. So let's move to the Reykjanes Peninsula and start with a time-lapse from there that looks like this since December 1st, and the interval between images is 24 hours. And notice that the time-lapse includes the South Iceland fracture zone. It's plenty of unrest all along the plate boundaries, all the way to the volcano Hekla, but it's a bit further east, so you don't see it this time. And when we let the earthquakes accumulate, the map looks like this since December 1st, and it looks like this since September 1st, or shortly after the last eruption came to an end. So we are still far away from any kind of norm, and the weakest spots are quite obvious. It's noticeable that there seems to be more activity now by the volcano Hengill, which is the only central volcano around, and it's believed that it has two magma chambers. And the plate boundaries, they pop well when we look at this in this format. So let's move to the westernmost part of the peninsula with a bit better resolution, and this lineup is just about where the last eruption occurred on the seafloor, an eruption that later would migrate onshore. And when we move further east, and this lineup shows us the dike that fed the two eruptions, we can also see quite clearly that there is way less seismic activity on the thickest landmass on the peninsula, or where we get the largest earthquakes, So everything around there is still locked and loaded. So like before, the seismic activity is simply moving around. And when we zoom into the town of Grindavík, we can see the reason why the town was almost evacuated last year. And overall, I can't say that I'm seeing anything new from this, but it is telling me that it's still a lot of unreleased energy down there. And all we can do is to hope that the next one comes up far away from inhabited areas. So this is actually quite thin update this time, but I usually do them when we get new information. And I'm gonna try to do them at least monthly or when things are slow. However, I do suspect that such a plan will not be needed within not so long time or when the next cycle starts. And due to how thin this was, I'm going to make this up to you with some footage from the plate boundaries. And I'm starting by the central volcano Hengill, just by the city. And from there, I'm going to move over to Lake Þingvallavatn. And this video should answer why I am so interested in the plate boundaries or all the spectacular visuals around them. So this footage is just a little part of my work last year. And those locations deserve, of course, more. So it's plenty of work for me to do into the future. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.